Hello there. You are about to learn how to create a fully automated funnel on the WordPress platform. So using different tools and softwares, but completely on WordPress, built on WordPress. And this covers like the big picture, the puzzle, how things fit together with adding people to an email list, letting them book appointments, or giving them access to different areas of your website or courses, depending on what they buy. It also covers how to send out abandoned cart email. So that entire process, not just creating the couple pages, but how all those pieces fit together. I was pulling my hair out for like 6 months trying to figure out the best solution to get this all integrated and working well, because there's a lot of tutorials on how to create a few different pages or upsells, but nothing on how the big picture all works. So let me show you what I created and how I set it up. So we have the sales page. I dropped the price like a whole bunch with everything going on. So people fill out their information here. And if they fill it out, but then don't check out, they'll automatically get two emails asking if something went wrong, if there are any issues, maybe they just got distracted, and giving them a link back to the sales page. So I have people had people actually go back to the sales page and buy again, or one person actually did have a technical issue, and people can opt in to be added to the email list. And right now have the coupon, which is being applied to every single person. And here's the one-click upsell where people can just tap the button and add this to their order, and it updates automatically as people go to check out. Then when they do this, they go to the first upsell, which is a 30-minute consultation as well as courses and ebooks. So if they say, yeah, I do want this, their card will be charged and I'll say, hey, you did the 30-minute consult, why not do the 2-hour one as well? And they can say yes or no. If they see this offer for the consult plus courses and say no, then it's like, hey, do you want just the courses for a lower price? And then the thank you page that they go on is different based off if they chose no consultation, a 30-minute consultation, which is what this is for, and it's got its own unique questionnaire, or the 2-hour consultation. So they can book it in my calendar. They can fill out a in-depth questionnaire, answer different questions, and then it'll send them reminders of when it's coming up. It'll create a Zoom link and I'll add it to both our calendars. So that's really, really cool. But here's the other automated portion that we're gonna talk about. So with my courses, which I created on WordPress, they automatically get an email creating an account. They can change the password if they want, where they get access to all my premium courses that they ordered. So they can see the ones they haven't ordered as well as links to ones that they already purchased, and they can actually access them and go through them and chart their progress with that. And then the last thing that's really cool and so important with my email list, they're actually added to the email list, but also they're tagged or added to a group where you can see like every single person who bought the different things. So this is every single person who bought the 14-day challenge, and I can email all those people, or I can send out another email that excludes people who already bought it if I want to pitch that product to my email list. So let's talk the different tools that I use. So Thrive Themes, I'm a huge fan of their whole membership thing. I think it's $19 per month for access to all 11 tools, since there's two here. So it's a page builder and capturing leads and things like that. Anytime like with a funnel, it's just a lot better than some of the other page builders and has a lot of things with collecting leads and doing split testing, which I do sometimes with my funnels, where you can have something, it's the same URL, but you can have different variations. So a certain percent will see one version, a certain percent will see the other, and you can see how the two or three or four variations compare with one another, and it makes it super easy doing it within Thrive. Elementor is a free alternative. I didn't like it quite as well as a page builder, and it doesn't have the other tools, but you can totally do all of this I'm talking about in Elementor. It's a little harder to create the courses and things like that if you're doing that, but it's totally a legit option. Those are affiliate links below, but I'm only an affiliate for products I've done thorough research for, that I use myself, and that I absolutely love. So if you're thinking about getting something, please use one of those links. So you can see I can just use my regular page builder, move stuff around, use all of the tools that I would in building a regular page. I can do split testing by clicking the AB, and then I can set it up so there's different variations of the page. If I'm running paid traffic, I just about always do split testing. So these buttons just jump you to the bottom of the page, and the checkout itself you do through Cartflows on that page. Cartflows is a really good WordPress solution where you're actually using your page builder and things like that. They do have a free version. It's not really a full funnel, but it is the best free solution in terms of what it offers. So here's the comparison of the regular versus the pro. So you don't get the upsells or the order bumps. You don't get downsells. So what does it do versus, it's integrated with WooCommerce, which is a popular one, but here's the difference. So WooCommerce, like this is your WooCommerce checkout page, and you can change things a little, but it just has to be like that. It can't really be exclusive to you or your brand or things like that. But if you're using even the free version, you can still have this full checkout page. You can't have the order bump, but you can have it where people fill in their info. It's within your brand and on the sales page, and then it takes them to this custom thank you page with the order details. So you can still build that all out. You just don't get that full funnel like you do with the pro version, which is like $25 a month. Cartflows is really built around WooCommerce, so you're going to use that, but it adds all the features and the pages and integrates it really well. So I was really looking hard for a completely free version that really stacked up for you, but the free version of Cartflows is the best that I found. The Cartflows Pro is actually on the lower end of funnel builders. A lot were like $50 to $300 a month, so pretty expensive. So not super cheap, but also not completely unaffordable at $25 a month. So let me first show you the full funnel. So you create all the different steps. So you categorize it as like a checkout page or upsell, downsell, and then you can point them to, okay, they chose yes on the upsell. They're going to the 2-hour upsell. Okay, they chose yes on that. They're going to the 2-hour thank you page. So that whole thing that we looked at previously. So if we go to this page, you go here to launch the page itself, but the exact options you choose here, and you can choose the product that you're gonna do. You can do variations, like different number of them. And that's also where we set up the order bump right here. So this is the full checkout page. If we do another one, like the upsell is a different type of page. There we just select what's the upsell product and where are we sending people afterwards. So if people click yes, where do they go? If they click no, where do they go from there? For the abandoned cart, when people enter in their info and then leave, I like this one. It's just a plugin. It's WooCommerce Recover Abandoned Cart. And it's just $49 one time. Cartflows does make a free version, which works great. It works flawlessly. The only difference is it just sends a more generic email out to everyone. So I want product specific emails of like, hey, you left this exact product, go back to this product page. That whole, I want to customize that experience based on each product, which the free versions that I found of all these programs, it's just a generic email that goes out to everyone. So this is the tool I like. You can set up the email templates so you connect it with the actual product itself, and then you can go and create the specific emails where it puts in their first name and say, hey, it looks like you tried to claim your free copy, so it's product specific. You can send people back to the planner page, and you can set it to go out 4 hours afterwards. So if you're doing the Cartflows one, it's free, but you just have to do a generic email like, hey, you left something in your cart, go back to this page to check out. If you're doing the appointments, the paid version, I do really like Book Like a Boss. It's just really clean and sleek and works perfectly in terms of like questionnaires and people booking the exact session like I was showing you, but Calendly does offer a free option which has some of the features, not the same level of reminders and booking, but it's a solid choice as well. You can create different appointments and a description as well as padding and the questionnaire for people to fill out. And then down here, they have an embed code so you can actually put it on your page and make that a part of your sales funnel where people can actually book you as a part of that sales funnel process. For email list itself, Mailerlite, I'm throwing you a completely free one as the best option. It's just really well integrated with actually being able to track purchases from emails, and it really, the free plan does not hold back at all. You get all the features you need. Everything I talk about, you can do on the free plan. I think that's a no-brainer. Wishlist member was really the missing piece of the puzzle, and the reason is it's so well integrated with WooCommerce as well as the email list. So what happens is someone makes a purchase, and then Wishlist member creates a membership level for them based off that purchase where they can access it. They get that automated email creating the account where they can access it. But then that also triggers where they're added to the email list group. So it'll actually like tag people with that group. I really tried for so long to get it to be where people could do WooCommerce, go to the checkout, make the order, and then get added to the proper email list, but just could not get it to work, even with Zapier and different tools and set it up so it should have been working, but never got it to work properly. I have heard that ActiveCampaign actually has that integration down pat, but it's only at their plus level, which is $49 a month with 1,000 contacts and goes up considerably from there. So I actually love Wishlist member just to integrate all of that really well. I got it as a one-time deal under $100 for lifetime access, but I think it's a $150 a year, so about $12 per month. And if you have courses and stuff, any content you're trying to protect, any sensitive things or things that people need to log in for, it's the perfect solution for that. So let me know if you want more details on like actually installing it, but I just want to show like the how-to of how to connect everything here. So once you have it, you have your different membership levels. So you can do one for each course. You can actually do where people need to pay ongoing to access stuff, like a membership site, but you can also do it to give people access to different content and things like that. Then we're gonna get into how it actually integrates with taking you from product to adding them to your email list correctly. So with that, there is integrations. So you can go, it gives step-by-step instructions on actually connecting it to the different payment providers, as well as you can use your API key to connect to your email list. So then here's what happens next. So under WooCommerce, you want to actually go to your products and find your exact product. I actually have it pulled up right here. So now with the product, this didn't used to be here, but it added a section that says Wishlist member. So anytime anyone buys that product from your site, you can add them to the membership level of your choosing. So it doesn't matter if it's the initial offer or if it's any sort of upsell. Anytime someone buys that, they'll get added to this level. So that does a couple cool things. First, yeah, if it's a course or membership area, now you can actually restrict the access. So someone buys it, they get added to that, and then suddenly they can access this course. You also in Wishlist member can send that email saying, hey, here's the course, log in right now, and because you've connected this rule to the course, they can access it immediately. But here's what it does that's really cool on the email front. So you select that integration, and once it's connected, you can say, hey, okay, this membership level, every time someone gets added to this membership level, add them to any one of your groups or lists or tags or things like that. So the process, again, that people go through is they buy your product, then that automatically adds them to the membership group and sends them an email where they can log in and access that. But then it also, it's connected here and will add them to your email list thing. So that's how it all works together. It took me a long time to figure that out. For the courses themselves, Thrive Apprentice is pretty cool because it actually creates it like a course, but you can still use all the same tools and you can add videos and different content and all the tools you're really used to, but people can track their progress. And with Wishlist Member, you can actually say, okay, give access if the user has subscribed to the following list. The last question you need to ask is WordPress the best platform to build out this sales funnel? Here's why it works really well for me. So I have my full website and the different blog posts and pages, and I can really integrate the sales funnel pages within that and keep it all under the Jacob LE brand. I'm also very familiar with WordPress, very quick at getting pages to look exactly the way I want. And there's a lot of people who are familiar with WordPress who can help you if things are breaking. I do think that Shopify, if you're doing a whole bunch of different products, that's kind of the gold standard right now, the industry standard of what people are choosing. If you only want just the sales funnel, just throw something up really quick that stands on its own and it's kind of like pre-made with templates and things like that. I have heard really good things about lead pages. That's what's been recommended to me the most. So you probably need the pro plan because the standard is very limited, but that I haven't used it personally, but it's been recommended by several different people. Now you have your funnel set up, but you also need traffic to it. And there's actually five huge ad mistakes that you definitely do not want to make. I actually made a full video detailing those five biggest mistakes that could be hurting your results. So click on that video right now to see what those are. Thank you so much for watching. Subscribe for weekly videos on growing your business, but check out that video now.